I'm David Johnson, pastor of New Tabor Brethren Church here in Caldwell, Texas, and this is Bible Boost. Today's subject is the common denominator. Now, do you remember in math class when you first got fractions and you began to learn about these? There's something that we called the common denominator. And when you look at it, you could see that the number on the bottom was the same, but the numbers on the tops were different. So the numbers on the tops are numerators, and the ones on the bottom are denominators. I'm the last person you want to be teaching you math, trust me. But this is something that we have learned. We use this phrase, common denominator, often. What does it mean? Common denominator is a feature shared by all members of a group. So the enemy has fractured God's church into many groups. He has. And, you know, now my fourth grade teacher, she'd be so proud that I'm using fractions in this, even though I didn't do very good in fractions. But the church is fractured. It's split. We have many different names, and a lot of people even mistake by saying, well, I'm this or I'm that, and I'm a different religion than you are. We're Christians, for goodness sakes. Methodists and Baptists aren't different religions. We just have different last names in the same family. We all belong in the family of God. Our numerators are different, but we have a common denominator. So we're mostly separated by doctrinal and method differences. That's the major differences that we have as different denominations. Cultural and human differences also separate us. These are just human things that get in our way. These things will not be in heaven. I want to tell you a story of an Advent candle. Many of you, I don't know if you have an Advent candle in your church, but this candle represents the shepherds, the prophets, Mary and Joseph, the wise men. And in some traditions, you have a candle in the middle that is white. It represents Jesus. Others have a pink candle. And when I first came here, I didn't know much about Advent candles, and I thought, we got to figure this out. I want to do it right if I'm going to do it. So I looked it up and found out how biblical. It's not biblical at all. It's just a human thing. It's a good thing. It's neat, but it's not something that is required by God. It's a human thing. And one Sunday, I had a new family come up, and I gave them what to read and told them to light the Advent candle. So they walked up. They did everything they were supposed to do. But when it came time to lighting the candle, they lit the, quote, wrong purple candle. You know, there's three purple candles up there, and they lit one out of sequence, you know. And after service, someone walked through the line and says, I am so aggravated. I'm so mad. I said, why are you so mad? I was full of the Holy Spirit. I just got through preaching. I was fired up. I said, why are you upset? And they said, that new family lit the wrong candle. And I looked at them. I said, okay, do you think Jesus is upset about this as you are? And the person said, no. I said, then I set you free from your tension. You see, that's a numerator. We focus on the denominator, that thing that we have common, which is Jesus, not our human differences of methodology. Here is our common feature. Let's look at this. First Corinthians chapter 2, verses 1 through 2. And so it was with me, brothers and sisters, when I came to you, I did not come with eloquence, Paul speaking, of human wisdom as I proclaimed to you the testimony about God. For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. He said, I'm coming to you not with the numerator. I'm coming to you with the common denominator that we have. King James Version, Colossians chapter 1, verses 17 and 18 says, and he, meaning Jesus, is before all things, and by him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. He's the chief. He's the feature. He's the common denominator. We may be different tribes as denominations, but we are all Israelites. We are all the family of God. When you look on your brothers and sisters from other denominations, be careful not to look on them with suspicion. They're children of God just like you are. The numerators are different, but the denominator we share is Christ and him crucified. And Christ is preeminent. You're going to find out you've got more in common with him than you think you do. Focus on the feature. And the feature is Jesus Christ, our common denominator, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you next time on Bible Boost.